ISOMED. iSolutions for your clean room. Products for USP 797 and USP 800 compliance.
This is a demonstration of the hazardous chemo drug spill kit. Contents include instructions for HD spill kit use, two HD spill caution signs, shoe covers, N95 masks, face shield, two pairs of large gloves, disposable goggles, chemo gown in extra large, plastic pan and plastic pusher, three 15 by 20 absorbent towels, surface safe two-step kit, HD exposure report. Personal contamination has occurred. Follow personal contamination procedures per facility's P&Ps. Open up HD spill kit and place containments of the kit in a clean surface. Put on your N95 mask or face shield and then proceed to put on other personal protective equipment or PPE. Use the two yellow hazard drug caution signs to mark the HD spill area. Once you have all the PPE on for liquid spills, place enough of the absorbent towels over the spill, carefully not to touch the HD spill. Allow time for the towels to thoroughly absorb the material. Once the absorbent towels are saturated, place them in the black RCRA waste container. Repeat these steps if necessary. If glass is involved with the spill, please use the plastic pan and plastic pusher to sweep up the glass fragments and dispose of them into the black RCRA container. At this time, please place any materials in the RCRA container that may have been exposed or containing HD, for example, tubing and IV bags. Once the liquid and items have been cleaned up and disposed of, wipe the contaminated surfaces with a surface-safe two-step applicator. Place the used surface wipes in the RCRA container. For solid spills, dampen the absorbent towels with the readily available water source. Use the dampened towel to physically remove HD from the affected surfaces. When ready to remove your PPE, do so in the following order. Outer pair of gloves, goggles, N95 mask or face shield, shoe covers, chemo gown. Lastly, remove the second pair of gloves and place everything in the black RCRA container. Close the container lid firmly, sealing the container and identifying the contents on the outside of the container per facility's P&Ps or SOPs.